Now, Dr. Robert Murphy, professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's start with these numbers here. Obviously, things moving very much in the wrong direction.
Yes, it's up everywhere worldwide. Omicron is just infecting everybody. The vaccinated people are getting infected at a very high rate, but they're not ending up in the hospital or the ICU.
Dr. Murphy, with all of the increase, the spike here, we're hearing about lots more friends, coworkers with this COVID. How do you know now if you have it? Because at the beginning, we were told it was a dry cough, it would impact your lungs. Yeah. Now hearing with Omicron, it may be more just cold-like symptoms. Should we be testing even if you just have a little cold now?
Yes, absolutely. That's a really good point, because this is acting more like an upper respiratory infection without really much lung involvement. So a sore throat, runny nose, just a simple cold symptoms, that could be COVID now. So if you have that, you need to get tested immediately.
Walk us through the study here from South Africa. Is there perhaps any good news here in terms of hospitalization percentages?
Yeah, no, there's several studies. There's a couple in the United Kingdom and the South African data. So in South Africa, about people that presented and got tested for COVID used to end up in the hospital about 20% of the time. They're noticing now, since Omicron has taken over so quickly, 2 to 4%. I mean, that's a dramatic drop. In the United Kingdom, the two studies, they have this very centralized medical system. They know where everybody is at any time in terms of hospital patients. It looks like the hospitalization rate is down by about 2/3.
So do you think that's positive for us here?
This is great. Vaccinated, unvaccinated, whatever it is, it's down, and that's good. But the number is so high, the hospitals are still filling up.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions here, starting with this. Hypothetically speaking, is it possible to achieve herd immunity with COVID, considering the number of breakthrough cases occurring?
Everyone is going to have some immunity, because everyone, particularly the unvaccinated, are going to get infected. I mean, that's just basically a given at this particular point. And so everyone will have some immunity, but it's not going to protect them from the next infection. It looks like the immunity begins to wane, decrease after a relatively short period of time, just a matter of a couple of months. Vaccines last a little bit longer, but like the Israelis have shown, they're about 2 months ahead of us in this whole vaccine situation. They're already starting to give the fourth shot, the second booster.
Do you think, really quick, with that fourth booster, is that what it's going to become now, just another one, a fifth one? Is that what we're going to start seeing?
Well, we'll see. That's a great question. We don't know yet. We're in the pandemic.
Yeah.
we're going to figure this out. But, you know, if you need a fourth booster.
All right, time for one more quick question here. Are there any studies that show there are more breakthrough cases of COVID in people who received the J&J vaccine?
Yeah, I mean, from the beginning, that's the problem with the J&J vaccine. In the beginning, I think it was 60, when they got approved, it was a 66.3% protection. And that was versus over 90% for both the Moderna and the Pfizer vaccine. It still got approved because it was a single shot. Now, if you give the two shots, that jumps up to about 75%. And the data are a little bit better in the United States, but it's always lagged behind the other ones. Now, staying out of the hospital, the ICU, and dying is the same.
Dr. Murphy, thanks so much for joining us. Of course, if you didn't get your question answered, he answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our WGN Morning News Facebook page, posted on there. Dr. Murphy, we're going to talk to you again on Monday. Enjoy your holiday this weekend.